Radha Dana Randa Yashoda Nanda Radha Dana Randa Yamuna Tiram Vanachari Yamuna Tiram Vanachari Jaya Radha Madam Kunjani Hari
Jaya
Рама, Рама, Хари, Хари.
Hare Krishna, dear devotees. I don't know Jai or not, we will see. Yeah. But I need your blessing. I need a lot of blessings, please. Because today Varadeshwari is absent, Dinadayal also, so I need to speak English, so I'll try. Yes. Some and another. We continue to read Bhagavatam, Canto 4, chapter 25, verse number 34. Ихадья сантам атманам. Yeah, I read it by myself. Ихадья сантам атманам видамана татах парам енеям нирмита вира пуришаранам атманахам. Word by word translation. Иха, here. Адья, today. Сантам, existing. Атманам, living entities. Видама, that much we know. На, not. Татах парам, beyond that. Ена, by whom. Иям, this. Нирмита, created. Вира, a great hero. Puri, city. Sharanam, resting place. Atmanaha, all of living entities. Translation: a great hero, we only know that we are existing in this place. We do not know what will come after. Indeed, we are so foolish that we do not care to understand who has created this beautiful place for our residence. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. This lack of Krishna consciousness is called ignorance. In Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.5, it is called Parabha Stavat Abodha Jataha. Everyone is born ignorant. The Bhagavatam therefore says that we are all born ignorant within this material world. In our ignorance, we may create nationalism, philanthropy, internationalism, science, philosophy, and so many other things. In one of Purports, Srila Prabhupada say, nationalism, internationalism, and all these idiotisms. The basic principle behind all this is ignorance. What then is the value of all this advancement of knowledge if the basic principle is ignorance? Unless a person comes to Krishna consciousness, all of his activities are defeated. This human form of life is especially meant to dissipate ignorance. But without understanding how to dissipate ignorance, people are planning and building many things. After death, however, all of this is finished. One more translation. A great hero, we only know that we are existing in this place. we do not know what will come after. Indeed, we are so foolish that we do not care to understand who has created this beautiful place for our residence. Омагьяна тимирандасья, кьянанджананджалакая, чакшурун милитам яна, тасмай шри гураве намаха, шри чайтанья манобиштам, стапитам яна бутале, своям рупах кадамах ям дадати сва, падантикам, нитьянандахам науми, сарванандахарам парам, харинама апрадам девам, авадута широмани, нама маха ваданьяя, Кришна према прадаяте, Кришная Кришна Чайтанья намне горд вишена махам, нила чала нивасая, нитяя параматмане, бала бадра субадрабхям, шри джаганатхе тена маха, хе Кришна каруна синдо, дина бандо джагатпате, гопиша гопика канта, радха канта намастуте, тапта канчана гауранги, радхе вриндаванешвари, вришабану суте деви, пранамами хари прием, Ванча калпата рубяща, крипа синдубья эвача, патита нам паване пьё, вайшнаве пьё намо намаха, джай шри Кришна чайтанья, прабу нитьянанда, шри адвайта гададхара, шри васади гора бхакта вринда, харе Кришна, Кришна Кришна, харе харе, харе рама, рама рама, харе харе, харе Кришна, Кришна Кришна, харе харе, харе рама, рама рама, харе харе, харе Кришна, Кришна Кришна, харе харе, харе рама, рама рама, харе харе. Нам умш нападая Кришна вшкарта лишь мати бхакти вигьянга с вами на тинамине бхакти вигьяна сами к там рада мадава савинам хриди пхумау чатат тама пратаршакам нам умех нам умш нападая Кришна вшкарта лишь мати бхакти виданта с вами на тинамине намасте сарасвати дейва горвани прачарине нирвишеша шуньявади пащати адеша тарине янтах правиш я мама вача мамам прасуптам санджи ваятя кила шакти дарах свадамна аньям шахаста чарана шравана твагадин Прана намо бхагавате пурушая тубьям. So we start. Please, who are speaking today? Who is speaking today was? What personality is speaking today was, which we read? Yes, Mataji Purajani. There is her second verse which he speaks. Yesterday, Damodar Prasad Prabhu gave a nice class. Today's verse has the same topic as yesterday. So I will try to follow the line of Damodar Prasad class and to try to add something to the topics discussed yesterday. But first, I would like to tell you a few stories from the life of my Guru Maharaja, His Holiness Bhakti Vigyana Goswami Maharaj. I think that these stories are related to our topics. Guru Maharaja studied at Moscow State University, the most prestigious educational institution in the former Soviet Union. He chose the chemistry department and he specialized in biochemistry. He was interested in origin of life. So he wanted to study the topic of life origin, how life comes from chemical elements. His parents were atheists and communists, so he was also an atheist. But his grandmother believed in God. Guru Maharaj told her that Gagarin flew into space but did not see God on a cloud. So there is no God. With this atheistic mentality, Maharaj began to study at the university. In the first year of studying, one of the students fell sick with cancer. The doctor said that he had very little time to left to live. He had very little time left to live. And this sick student continued to go to the university and passed the exams until his death. Guru Maharaj was shocked. No one knows what to do before death and continue to lead his usual life. After the death of this student, Guru Maharaj asked students in the course what they would do if they knew that they were about to die. None of the students knew the answers to this question. Only one student said that he would commit suicide without waiting for death. And this incident made a deep impression on Maharaj. Everyone understands that we will die, and no one knows how to prepare for death. Then it turned out that there was one Baptist in the course, and this student was expelled from the university in disgrace because religion was forbidden in the Soviet Union. Maharaj successfully graduated from the university, entered the graduate school, and was a talented, promising young scientist. But day by day, he began to understand that despite all scientific activity that was carried out at the universities and other institutions, despite the huge financial costs, despite a large number of outstanding scientists, the question of the origin of life remains unsolved. A huge number of experiments were being carried out, but there was no success in solving the problem of the origin of life. And he began to feel more and more disappointed with scientific activity. And then he met a devotee. But that is another story. And why did I tell these stories? Srila Prabhupada, in his very wonderful paper to this verse, writes, "This lack of Krishna consciousness is called ignorance. Everyone is born ignorant. In our ignorance, we may create nationalism, philanthropy, internationalism, science, philosophy, and so many other things. The basic principle behind all this is ignorance. What then is the value of all this advancement of knowledge if the basic principle is ignorance? Unless a person comes to Krishna consciousness, all of his activities are defeated." The stories from Guru Maharaj's life illustrated that really all scientific achievements are illusion and ignorance, although they seem important and great. All these achievements increase misery of human life and lead away from understanding of the utmost goal of human life. Yesterday, Damodar Prasad Prabhu mentioned that the soul is always full of knowledge and blessing. The soul is always pure, but we see that living beings are conditioned. Living beings are in ignorance. Srila Prabhupada writes, "Everybody is born ignorant." Lord Rishabhadev instructed his sons, "As long as one does not inquire about spiritual values of life, one is defeated and subjected to misery arising from ignorance." So in the conditioned state, the soul is covered with ignorance. The soul wants to enjoy in the material world. To do this, the soul must forget about God. God is very strongly manifested in the material world. He created this world, he supports this world. Everything in this world is his energy. The God is everywhere in this world, but we must forget about him. To prevent us from seeing God in the material world, Brahma, at the very beginning of his Visarga, second creation, created five envelopes of ignorance. These five envelopes of ignorance are Tamishra, Andatamishra, Tamas, Moha, and Mahamoha. Tamishra means because of envy, the living entity wants to enjoy as the Lord. Andatamishra means a living being believes that with the death of this body, all is finished. Tamas means the soul forgets her spiritual nature. Moha means the soul thinks that everything relating to the body belongs to me. Mahamoha thinks that soul wants more and more material pleasures. There are five very huge and very strong envelope of ignorance, which covered us. And after creating this envelope, Lord Brahma shuddered and left his body. And we are living covered by these five envelopes. This is our ignorance. Please imagine, it's very difficult to escape from this ignorance. Bhagavad Gita says about this. It was mentioned that the soul is Tathastha Shakti, but the soul belongs to the highest spiritual energy. The soul is covered by the illusory material energy. Spiritual energy is higher and stronger than material energy. All of us understand this point. But how the lower energy can enslave the higher energy? It's impossible. The lower energy cannot enslave the higher energy, but it did this. We are covered by, we higher energy are covered by lower energy. And what is the problem? The problem is that the soul is very, 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 very small. And the illusionary energy, all these envelopes of ignorance are very, very huge compared to the soul. And they are able to cover this small spiritual path. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur provides an excellent explanation with analogy. Are clouds able to cover the sun? Are clouds able to cover the sun?
Yes or no?
Yes, yes. Today we can see sun today. But sun is in the sky, but we can see the sun. Why? Because clouds cover the sun. And very, very tight cover it. No sun. But if we compare the size of the sun and the size of the clouds, the sun is huge and clouds are small. Moreover, the sun creates these clouds. And then these clouds cover the sun. So we see that something weaker can close something more powerful. We see this point that something weaker can close something more powerful. So the illusionary energy more weaker can close individual soul more powerful. And the same thing happens to the soul. When something weaker, the material energy covers something stronger, spiritual energy. It's one of explanation how material energy can cover our spiritual soul. And the second explanation is very, very interesting. It's sound like because the God wants this. It's the second explanation. And if the God wants something, it will be. In his purport to the verse number 33, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur writes, the spiritual meaning of this history is the ignorance which covers the knowledge of the jiva. The jiva should not claim to know the Lord. And this is, there are two lines in this history of King Purajana. The first line is that Puranjani is the intelligence of human being. And the second line is that Puranjani is the ignorance. There are two lines in this history. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur writes. And in this verse, we can see that this beautiful woman in this allegory of King Puranjana is ignorance. Srila Prabhupada in purport writes, this lack of Krishna consciousness is called ignorance. Everybody is born ignorant. In our ignorance, according to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, we claim to know the Lord. We don't want to know anything about what about Lord in our ignorance. We don't want to know anything about God, about this world, about the goal of our life. Exactly this is speaking about Puranjani in these words. Puranjani says, indeed, We are so foolish that we do not care to understand who has created this beautiful place for our residence. We are ordinary people not care to understand how this world is created, really. Modern society is very proud of modern science. But Srila Prabhupada says that the basic principle behind all this is ignorance. One amazing example of this ignorance is the big explosion theory of the origin of this world. I think you all hear about this theory. Now in Ukraine, there are many big and small explosions, a lot of explosions. And as a result, nothing is created. Everything is only destroyed. Let's take a few scientific facts. It is known that if the gravitational constant G was were slightly different, the universe would not be stable. It would either shrink or fly apart. Could such accuracy happen by chance? It's amazing. Let's take water. When water freezes, ice forms. All of us know this fact. The density of ice is less than the density of water. As a result, in winter, when rivers and lakes freeze, ice is on the top of rivers and lakes, and unfrozen water is under the ice, in which fish and other inhabitants of the waters can swim all winter. If ice were heavier than water, in winter, when rivers and lakes freeze, the ice would sink to the bottom. As a result of this, all reservoirs would completely freeze over, and all fish would die. And the last example is the clouds. Above our heads, in cloudy weather, there are thousands of tons of water in form of clouds. And this water does not fall on our heads. Why? Because the water in the clouds is in the form of tiny droplets that can float in the air. When it rains, these tons of water fall to the ground in the form of small droplets and benefit the plants, water them. And what happens if these tons of water pour it onto the earth from a great haze in the form of continuous mass of water? These tons of water would destroy all life on earth. And such examples on the fundamental structure of our world can be continued endlessly. How do these tons of water rise to great heights? To ride this water would require many trains with water tanks, large amount of energy and money. But in nature, for this purpose, there is a law of evaporation of water from the surface of reservoirs. For everything to be so wonderful arranged and work so wonderful, some had to create all this and do all this. And we, by our incredible grace and luck, know who created this world, yes? Who created this world? We know.
Who created this world?
Yes, who created this world?
Brahma,
but it's second creator. He do Visarga only, but the first creator is Krishna. Krishna, yes, the first creator is Krishna. But ordinary people don't even want to think about it. As Puranjani says in this verse, indeed, we are so foolish that we do not care to understand who has created this beautiful place for our residence. This is our foolishness. In the purport to this verse, Srila Prabhupada writes, this human form of life is especially meant to dissipate ignorance. It's the only aim of human life, to dissipate ignorance. And Lord Chaitanya gave Kali Yuga people the most powerful method how to destroy in ignorance. What is this method?
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Yes, he brings Harinama Sankirtana. And we are very, very lucky. And his special benefit is that he fulfill Harinam, Hare Krishna name with prema. It's only in Lord Chaitanya Hare Krishna mantra is. And Bhaktivinod Thakur, Bhaktisiddhanta, Lord Chaitanya gave people Raganuga Bhakti method. His method was pure Raganuga, without any Vaidisadhana Bhakti. What Lord Chaitanya brought to this world. Then Bhaktivinod Thakur, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, and Srila Prabhupada adopted this practice for us. Now we are practicing Vaidya Sadhana Bhakti. We called this method such in such way. We are sadhaks. That means people who are doing sadhana. The word sadhana can be translated as a means to achieve something. It's the translation of word sadhana. That is, in principle, everyone in this world is engaged in sadhana. They just don't call their activities as sadhana. For example, to become a musician, you need to practice music for at least several hours a day, every day. To become an Olympic champion, you must need to do this and that every way, every day also. So this is sadhana, to achieve this or that goal. But usually we use the word sadhana for spiritual purpose. And let us read the definition of sadhana bhakti, not sadhana, but sadhana bhakti from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.2.2. Kriti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhava sa sadhana bhidha nitya sadhasya bhava sya prakayam hridi sadhyata. This was written by Rupa Goswami. And the translation is: when transcendental devotional service, which bestows love for Krishna, is performed by the senses, it is called sadhana bhakti, or regulating devotional service. Devotion eternally exists in the heart of every living being. The practice of devotional service is meant to awaken this eternal devotion. To put it more briefly, when we said what is sadhana, we said that sadhana bhakti is an activity performed with the senses to obtain bhava. So is our usual definition of sadhana. Sadhana bhakti is an activity performed with the senses to obtain bhava. And in Patanjali Muni scriptures, it is said that any activity, in order to be successful, must have three components. What do you mean? What are these three components of every activity to be successful?
I'm sorry, can you ask again?
In Patanjali Muni scriptures, it is said that any activity, in order to be successful, must have three components. And what are these three components? What do you mean?
Three components
of activity to be successful. Every activity, not only sadhana, sadhana bhakti, every activity.
So one is the Lord's approval.
Every activity, not the spiritual, every ordinary activity also.
So one is that the sanction of God.
Yes, it's you speaks as a bhakta, but in common sense, these three topics are goal, ritual, and mood. Goal, ritual, and mood. Ritual, what we are doing.
Our mood.
So, to achieve some results during activity, we must understand a goal. Yes? Do you agree? And if maybe if we ask ordinary people in the street what is the goal of their activities, how do you think, can they answer what is their goal or not?
No, they can't really.
Really can't, yes. A lot of people do things unconsciously. They don't know what is the goal of what they are doing. So the first is a goal. Second is ritual or activities which we are doing to obtain this goal. And the second is a mood. A mood in which we are doing this activity. And let us look at this with example of sadhana bhakti. What is the goal of sadhana bhakti? What is the goal of sadhana bhakti?
To attain Krishna prema.
Krishna prema, yes. This. What is our ritual? What we are doing to obtain this goal?
Chant.
We have 9 methods of bhakti, yes? All of us know these methods. Shravanam, kirtanam, vishnoksmaranam, vandanam, padasevanam, archanam, dasyam, sakyam, atmanivedanam. This is our ritual. We do these things. And the third is mood. And what is the mood of our activities in which we must do our activity to obtain the goal, prema bhakti? Perfect, yes. This is our mood, and this is described in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu also. And if we look to the first 2 lines from the definition of sadhana bhakti, we can read Kriti Sadhya Bhavet Sadhya Bhavasa Sadhana Abhidha. And there is a word combination Sadhya Bhava. Do you ever hear this word Sadhya Bhava?
No.
No, yes. And Rupa Goswami and commentators of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu said that Sadhya Bhava is very, very important, because Sadhya Bhava is the mood of our sadhana. And if there is no mood, then the practice will be mechanical, and in the case of sadhana bhakti, will not lead to the goal. In other words, if we have not sadhya bhava, our sadhana bhakti will not lead us to the goal. And from these 3 parts of activity, goal, ritual, and the mood, what is the most difficult in practicing bhakti? What part is the most difficult?
Mood,
yes. And it's the most difficult, and it's the most important, yes?
Yes.
Yes, why is the most important?
Because it's the internal intention.
Yes. If there is no mood, then the practice will be mechanical, and in the case of sadhana bhakti, will not lead to the goal. If we have not proper mood, we'll not achieve the goal of our practice. It's very, very important for us, because sometimes we concentrated on the inner part of our activity and not look to the we concentrated on the outer part of our activity and don't look to the our inner part. And there is very, very important thing that the more subtle the activity is, the more important is the mood. And what does it mean? If I sweep the floor, then in whatever mood I do it, the floor will be swept. The result, a clean floor, will be achieved. Am I agree or am I sad? What I think about this or I think about that, I will sweep this floor and the result will be achieved. If I do asanas in Hatha Yoga, then the mood is more important since the activity is more subtle. If I do asanas with meditation, the result is better. But regardless of mood, some result in asanas will be obtained. The practice of bhakti is the most subtle activity. Therefore, mood is very, very important to get the result. You can perform the same activity. For example, perform arati. Mataji now is performing arati. You can perform arati. But you can do it for show, to show what a nice pujari I am. Please look at me. It's one mood. Or you can do arati to please the Lord. It doesn't matter if they look at you or not. In any method of bhakti, mood is very, very important. Because I am pujari in the surface, I not achieve any result of my activity. The sadhana of bhakti will indeed become the sadhana of bhakti while doing it we know the goal, the attainment of bhakti. So the sadhana really became sadhana if we know the goal. Otherwise, it's a good schedule of our day, not as more. It's only a blissful daily routine if we do sadhana and know the goal of this sadhana. And in the definition of sadhana bhakti, there is an expression sadhya bhakti. And acharyas say that activity is called sadhana when we do something with our senses along with sadhya bhava. So please mention it, that we must do sadhana with our senses with sadhya bhava. And what is sadhya bhava? We know that our practice is unique because our practice is simultaneously sadhana and sadhya. I think you hear about it, yes? That our practice is simultaneously sadhana and sadhya.
The goal and the way is the same.
The same, yes. It's very unique because, for example, when one is studying in university, the sadhana is studying, yes, but the goal is to achieve diploma, go to work, and so on. The sadhana and sadhya differs. But in our method, sadhana and sadhya are the same. And sadhya means goal, yes? Because we say sadhana and sadhya are the same. Sadhya means goal. Bhava means emotion of mood. And Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, in the commentary on this verse from Bhakti Rasamrita Singhu, defines sadhya bhava as that which gives rise to bhava bhakti. So, due to sadhana, sadhya bhava, we achieve bhava bhakti. Because it gives rise to bhava bhakti. And what is sadhya bhava in more detail? One explanation of sadhya bhava is when I practice, I remember the goal I want to achieve. For example, when I chant the holy name, I remember that my goal is to gain love to Krishna. The second explanation of sadhya bhava is I practice devotional service with the same bhava that I want to achieve. I try to practice this bhava. I don't have love yet, but I try to pronounce the holy name as if I have love. We often hear this advice when chanting the holy name. Especially often I heard this from Sachinandana Swami Maharaj. And I think you understand that sadhya bhava is very, very very, very important, yes, for our practice. And how can we achieve this sadhana bhava? Understanding of the goal and the mood of this goal. And there are several recommendations. First, this is associated with devotees. Second, listen to senior devotees. Third, hear about sadhya bhava, which is described in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Srila Prabhupada translated the 10th canto for us in the very, very early days of ISKCON as a Krishna book, because we must know this bhava, so that we come into contact with this bhava. Fourth, Singh bhajans that contain this bhava, glorified this bhava. And gradually, step by step, we will join with this bhava, become saturated with this bhava. And then surely our practice will not be mechanical. And we will achieve our goal. Which goal? Krishna Prema Bhakti. And this all what I can say. So maybe you have some comments, questions, and so on.
Thank you very much for the lecture and to make the importance how the mood, the study of bhava is very important. Then you mentioned the different methods how to get this study of bhava. Can you again mention this?
About what?
How to attain.
So that, yes, we have four steps which acharyas proposed to us to achieve this sadhya bhava. First is associate with devotees. We must associate with chisaza, but not only for some ordinary speaks, but we must to speak about Krishna. It's the goal of our association. Second, we must listen to senior devotees. Also, it's very important because they have such a bhava. Third, we must hear from Sadhya Bhava, which is described in the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. My Guru Maharaj explained that we must not only study philosophy, we must study philosophy, of course, but also we must come into contact with bhava, which we want to obtain. We must to know what we want to obtain, because the important thing to obtain Krishna Prema Bhakti is big desire to obtain it, yes? And to have this desire, we must to know what I want to obtain. Otherwise, how I can have such desire to obtain something, I don't know what. So we must have desire to go to spiritual world, to play with Krishna and so on. So we must read 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam. And Srila Prabhupada translated the 10th canto in the very, very early days of ISKCON, yes, as Krishna book. Because he understood that we must come into contact with this bhava. And the fourth is sin bhajans. It's very, very important thing also. It's very difficult for me because I am not singer, but I understand this very, very important. We must sing bhajans, and due to these four steps, so day by day, we will join with this bhava and become saturated with this bhava. And now we sing some bhajans. Yes, we sing in the morning Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur bhajan. Yes, then during Guru Puja, we also Guru Vandana sing. But I'm afraid that we sing it somehow mechanically. We don't know the meaning of these bhajans, and when we are singing, we don't think about the meaning. Sometimes I do this, and when I think about the meaning, it's another way to sing without mechanically without this. So we have this method now, we sing bhajans, but also it is very important the way how we sing these bhajans. And this I can say about this. Several minutes maybe.
These five layers of ignorance, uh-huh. They are described where?
They are described in the third canto, where the Maitreya Muni described the creation of this world. When he described Visarga, secondary creation.
Okay.
If you want, I can sent you the precise number. I don't mention it here. It's very important, these five great envelopes which cover us. And this is the first step of creation of Brahma, because we must forget about God. Without this, we can try to enjoy our senses in this world. But God is very brightly in this world. He is everywhere in this world. So Brahma need to create these five envelopes, and after this, he left his body, because these envelopes were awful for Brahmas. Yes, but the body of Brahma consists of intellect, and when Shastra said that Brahma left his body, it's several times said in Srimad Bhagavatam, it means that Brahma left his mood, because his body consists of intellects. So, mood. When it is said that he left his body, it's not means that he died completely. He left his mood and stay in another mood. So, thank you very much for listening. Thank you for blessings. Thank you for questions. Grantaraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Gaur Premananda.
Chestaruba means endeavors. Okay. And so both of them are very important. And Kavarupa maybe it's more important than Chestaruba.
Kavarupa is
more important than Chestaruba, yes. But always we don't understand.